Hey guys, today I show you how I fixed my monitor. It started to burn a couple of days ago and was really scary. It's a Dell U3415W. And spoiler alert, I edited this video on the monitor, so it worked. This video is a little bit longer than my normal videos, but I tried to put everything I did into the video. I hope you enjoy. Bye bye. Okay guys, so last evening something scary happened. I was sitting on my PC and I was like smelling really bad. I didn't know what it was. And then I checked all my computer equipment. And when I got to the monitor, it smelled really bad and it was really hot on the backside. So I pulled out the plug and this came out. So, oops, something like here. It started to melting. I don't know, maybe it was like a shorting or I don't know. And when I pulled it out, I also pulled this little thing out from the monitor itself. And now the monitor is not working anymore. So what I'm trying to do is to open up the case and then fixing the power plug, and maybe it works again or not. Anyway, let's try it. There are these little openings here, and maybe we can slip in with a screwdriver and open up the case. So let's find out. Okay, I think we got it. And let's check it out. Okay, we broke some, or I broke some. Okay, now you can see it better. But it looks like it's mounted with some screws. Maybe we are lucky and we can remove it and replace the plug. Let's see. And those. Okay, so here is the power board and everything is nice and modular, so maybe we can fix it. Let's see. Up. You can see here's the let's see if we can remove this one. And here you have it. You can see where the shortage happened. Let's see if we can clean this up. Thank you. Okay, searched online for this adapter, but I couldn't find any. Either they are too big, or the pin layout doesn't fit, or I don't know, very hard to find. So from another project, I got those left here. And now I'm trying to print out a little adapter. And I will connect this with some cables like this. I will secure them later with some solder just to be extra sure. So I'm screwing in this distance things, because the plug I use, it's bigger than the one they used before, just to give me some space here. So here are the two screws. So let's see if this works space-wise. You can see the 3D printed part. So the cables are not accessible. You can touch it with your hand. Don't forget to put on the sleeves. Okay, so here's the board with the soldered cables. Oh no, let's try to assemble this again. As you saw, the fix that I made worked, but I was a little bit concerned because the PCB of the power supply was a little bit scorched, and also some of the tracks were loose. So I found this on the internet. The whole replacement board is just $20. I will put a link down below. And this is the name of the replacement part. I also put the name in the link where I found it down below. And now we change the board. It's the same procedure as before, but without all the soldering and stuff.